Told you that this magic stone works like a power bank to you. It's like whenever you get that stone, you find something to be grateful about. So I told you that if you are in the middle of something, you are stressful, your self-talk is that I'm what will happen if I don't perform good or something like that, then it will affect your attitude. So that will become negative and the result will change to negative. And similarly, when you find that stone and you become or find something to be grateful about, your self-talk instantly changes. Your mind shifts from negative thought to a positive thought. As I told you, your mind can either think in a positive way or in a negative way. Both hormones cannot flow in your body at the same time. Your self-talk immediately changes to the positive one, and instantly your attitude changes from negative to the positive side. And if the attitude changes, it will affect your result and it will change to the positive one. So I hope you understand this circle and use that stone in your daily practices too. Fourthly, you'll ask me why you need this stone to feel gratitude. You can feel gratitude anyways, but it sounds similar that God is everywhere and why you need to go to temple to pray for it. I know you can feel the difference of energy while praying at home and while praying in the temple. In the temple, we actually circulate our energy with the deity. We are circulating our energy of trust, of hope, of hoping for the best, I must say. And this difference you can feel with the stone also. If you have anyone or who can sense the aura, I'll ask you to sense, ask him to sense the aura of your stone today, and after again to sense the aura after you practice it for 2 to 3 days, there will be a major difference in the aura of this stone. So it will act like a really magic stone for you then. The fifth point is, you'll ask me why we should practice it only at night time or before you go to sleep. The logic behind it is, whatever you read or whatever you practice before sleeping, it actually enters your subconscious mind directly. I'll explain you how your mind works, then you'll understand it much better. See how your mind works. Mind has two parts, the conscious mind and the subconscious mind. The conscious mind deals with analysis, logic and planning. And for example, if you are making some goal, say for example, you are making a goal to build a big house. So your mind will first analyze it if the goal is right. Logically, it suits you or it doesn't suit you. And then if it will start making plans for it, and if this process is been surpassed by your goals, then it will end surpass this filter too. This is a filter between the conscious and the subconscious mind, and when the idea is been accepted by your subconscious mind, the mind will start creating opportunities for your goal, solve any problem related or obstructing to your goal come into reality. Then it will produce instantly energy to accomplish that particular goal, and it will make or keep you in good health. And divine planning is that everything will go according to your will or according to the desired or desirable thing will happen to accomplish your goal. And when consciously, when your subconscious mind accepts your goal consciously, you will identify opportunity in the direction of completing your goal. You will take proper actions for it, and then you will finally be successful in accomplishing your goal. And if you have seen the movie The Secret, they talk about the subconscious mind. Any idea which enters our subconscious mind will instantly attract more similar ideas into our life. So while sleeping, you'll say your conscious mind sleeps. It's like when you sleep, you don't know how many time you take turns, or I was sleeping by placing my face this left side, or I was sleeping by facing my face right side, now it is to the left side. You don't know what has happened through the whole night. Actually, your conscious mind is sleeping, but your subconscious mind is active. To prove it, I can say that you are breathing throughout the whole night. Your kidney is working, your heart is working. Those all organs are working, which are controlled by your subconscious mind. So when you are about to sleep, this filter of yours, which I can say the filter of analysis, logic, get thinner and thinner as you go to sleep. So while sleeping, if you practice this habit of magic stone or gratitude stone, actually you are impregnating your idea of gratitude into your subconscious mind. So this subconscious mind of yours will attract more things to be grateful for. So indirectly, you are creating magic into your life by impregnating this attitude of gratitude into your subconscious mind. I hope this is very complicated, I know, but I hope you you have understood it. If you have any doubt, you can call me or message me. So now with the activity 1, that is you are counting your blessings in the morning, and with the activity 2, you are counting your best blessing at night time. So gratitude in the morning and gratitude at the night. The basic idea behind is that you get into habit of being grateful for the things you have in your life. This book is actually designed to change your life very fast with the attitude of gratitude. So I hope you do both the activities regularly for the next 26 days and enjoy the magic around you. So bye bye, meet you tomorrow.